first freeze marks the end of the season for day-neutral strawberries. At this point, it's time to remove the plants and clean up the field, making way for a new crop to be rotated in the following spring. The plants are removed according to organic certification requirements, but also to keep the field clean from disease pathogens. At the Minnesota Agricultural Experiment Station in St. Paul, Mary Rogers' research group said goodbye to the plants in their day-neutral strawberry trials on October 18th. This date followed a hard freeze that froze the berries solid, halting plant growth and fruit production. This also coincided with the date the irrigation water was turned off at the farm. Removing a day-neutral strawberry planting is simple, but it's also time-consuming for small farms without access to large equipment. This is the case for the student organic farm, which relies on small hand tools and elbow grease to get things done. For this team's research, their third of an acre of organic day-neutral strawberries were planted on alternating rows of plastic and paper mulch as part of a trial comparing the effectiveness of various mulches. The research team is testing whether paper mulch can be a viable and more sustainable alternative to plastic mulch in Minnesota and Wisconsin. Step one in fall cleanup is to remove the plants. In order to compost the plants, the crew pulled them out and collected them into buckets. Then we walked the buckets of plants over to a pile so they can be hauled away for composting. After removing the plants, the plastic needed to be completely discarded. It's important to us that we don't leave any shards of plastic behind in our trials. But since the aisles between the rows were covered with living grass all season, the buried edges of the plastic were solidly in place under somewhat compacted soil. Because of this, we had to use a shovel to loosen the plastic from the ground. The paper mulch had disintegrated several weeks ago, so this step could be skipped on those rows. While dislodging the plastic, a third person followed behind to roll it up. This white-on-black plastic is then disposed of according to organic certification requirements, making sure that no pieces are left in the soil. The final step in cleanup is to disconnect the irrigation. We disconnected the irrigation tubing and tape from the main irrigation line, as well as the fertigation tank. Since the tape can't be used again, it was pulled into a pile for disposal. With the help of student volunteers, it took seven people about 4.5 hours to clean up the third of an acre field. On large commercial farms, a soil lifter and plastic retriever would be used for fall cleanup, since our method is too time-consuming to be scaled up to a large farm. But it works well for a small operation like those in the Midwest, while also reducing soil disturbance and allowing the grass aisles to remain over the winter. For more information on growing day-neutral strawberries, visit the University of Minnesota Extension Strawberry Guide online at extension.umn.edu/strawberry-farming. This research is funded by two grant programs, the USDA NEFA Organic Transitions Program and North Central Region's SARE Program.